Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ng News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Last week's episode covered only Angular 21, and that's why this episode covers the last 2 weeks instead, as usual, just one. There's some movement on the Zoneless front. First, there is a PR which proposes to elevate Zoneless to stable already in the upcoming version 20.2. That's quite surprising given that Zoneless just entered developer preview with version 20. It shows that the Angular team seems pretty confident about its production readiness. And there's another PR in the works to make Zoneless the default, but that won't land in the 20 range. If accepted, the earliest we'll see it is in Angular version 21. PrimeNG is one of the most popular UI libraries for Angular. It was now released in version 20 without many breaking changes. So far, so good. But there was a surprise. There will be a parallel library called PrimeNGX, which will use the modern features of Angular, like signals, like Zoneless, beta testing, and more. PrimeNG 20 isn't going anywhere though. It will remain active and continue receiving new features, just not through breaking changes. Instead, new features will be introduced alongside the existing ones. That's a strategy we've already seen Angular apply quite successfully. Work on PrimeNGX is planned for Q4 this year. And for more information, you can always check out the links in this video. Progress continues on the new animations system in Angular. As previously mentioned, there was an RFC to introduce native support for animations and also to support better third-party libraries. Eventually, this will lead to the deprecation of the Angular Animations library. Eventually could already mean Angular version 20.2. There is now a PR with this intention. This PR also notes the intention to remove Angular Animations entirely in version 22.2. You can already try it out via the official StackBlitz demo, and Igor Sedov didn't miss the chance to showcase it in a quick video. The monthly Q&A session with Mark and Jeremy always brings good insights, but this time it had something extra. Jeremy demoed a full implementation of the card game's Spades, built with the help of Gemini. It's a great example of what AI-assisted coding could look like in practice. What makes it really interesting is that Jeremy did the same thing 3 years ago, but without AI. So we can now compare the two episodes to find out which approach is more productive. In my opinion, it was the one without AI, but please check it out on your own and make your own decision. ng News is going into a short holiday break, but not for too long. So enjoy the time and see you soon. Goodbye.